Good day to all of you. Myself, Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dugar College, Bikaner. Welcome all of you. Today's MSc final topic for discussion is magnetron. First of all, what is magnetron? Magnetron is a device that generates high power electromagnetic. What is magnetron? Which generates high power electromagnetic waves. It is basically considered as the self-excited microwave oscillator. Self-excited. That means automatically self-excited. No external excitement is given. Self-excited microwave oscillator. And also known as crossed field device, that means electric and magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other. Because the reason behind calling is that the electric and magnetic field produced inside the tube are mutually perpendicular to each other, thus the two fields are crossing each other. So this is known as crossed field device. Here we discuss about a normal discussion is given here, mathematical aspects is not given, only general idea becomes. In next lecture we also learn about the mathematical aspects. Okay, magnetron operating principle, number 2 construction, number 3 working, number 4 frequency, pushing and pulling, number 5 advantages, number 6 disadvantages, number 7 applications. Okay. Now, operating principle. I tell you earlier that in physics, basic principle is important. Construction, working and basic principle. And few mathematical aspects or relations which we are essential to know about the according to the syllabus. Okay, a magnetron is basically a vacuum tube. What is magnetron? Nothing but it is a vacuum tube of high power having multiple cavities. There are many kinds of magnetrons. Here in this article we are showing or we are explaining the multiple cavity magnetron operating principle. It is also known as KVT magnetron because of the presence of anode in the resonant cavity of the tube. KVT magnetron because anode is present in the resonant cavity of the tube. Okay. The operating principle of a magnetron is such that when electrons interact with the electric and magnetic field in the cavity. In the cavity, electron interact with the electric and magnetic field. Okay? Then high power oscillations get generated. Okay? Magnetrons are majorly used in radar as being the only high power source of RF. High power source of radio frequency signal. Due to this reason, magnetrons are majorly used in technology. Okay, as a power oscillator, despite of a power amplifier, it is used as power oscillator. And magnetron invented by the Hull, Albert Hull, in 1921. And after that, improved high power cavity magnetron was invented in 1940. And the scientists are John Randall and Harry Booch. So, invention is initially by Hull in 1921 and improved high power cavity magnetron was invented by Randall and Booch in 1940. Here in this article, we discuss about how a cavity magnetron works. Okay, but before this, we must know how a magnetron is constructed. constructed. Construction of a magnetron. Here the figure shows 8 cavity magnetron. The number of cavities 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is known as 8 cavity magnetron. Here inside circle, this circle is known as cathode. Outside boundary, this is known as anode. Okay, and the space between cathode and anode is known as interaction space, and electric field is between from where electric field is applied, because we must give the phase change of 180 degree between alternate cavities. One cavity is positive and next is negative, again positive. So this gives the electric field. A cylindrical magnet, structure of magnetron. A cylindrical magnetron has a cylindrical cathode of a certain length and radius present at the central, around which a cylindrical anode is present. Cylindrical cathode and cylindrical anode. The cavity is present in the circumference of the anode at equal spacing. The cavities are present at circumference of the anode at equal spacing. These are cavities. Okay. Also, the area existing between the anode and cathode of the tube, also known as interaction space or region. The area between cathode and anode, this area is known as interaction space or region. It is to be noted here that there exists a phase difference of 180 degree between adjacent cavity. Therefore, cavities will transfer their excitation from one cavity to another with a phase shift of 180. Positive, negative. Positive, negative. So, a phase difference of 180 degree between two adjacent cavities. Thus, we can say that if one plate is positive, then automatically its adjacent plate, that means next plate, is negative. So, it is clearly shown in the figure. Now, we can say that edges and cavities show 180 degree phase apart relation. Okay. As we have already discussed that E and B are perpendicular to each other. Here, magnetic field is generated by using a permanent magnet. Important point is that magnetic field is generated using a permanent magnet. Now, working of magnetron. Working of magnetron. The excitation to the cathode of the magnet is provided by a DC supply. Normally, what we have done in many experiments, we see that excitation of the electrons is due to DC power supply, and similar cause of emission of electron is here. Okay, so excitation to the cathode of the magnetron is provided by a DC supply, which causes the emergence of the electrons from it. Here in this section, we will discuss the working of magnetron. That is very important part for you. Working of electron, and the working is under two categories. Point to be noted that there are two categories of working. Okay, first, without applying RF input, without applying RF radio frequency input to the anode, and the second one is application of RF input to the anode. Okay, so first we discuss about the when RF input is not present. There are many cases. Case number one, when the magnetic field is zero or absent. If there is no magnetic field or absence of magnetic field, what will happen? When a magnetic field is absent, an electron emerging from the cathode and radially moves towards the cathode. Because the magnetic field is not present, so the path is straight line, because curved path is due to presence of magnetic field, or that is due to magnetic field. Okay, so in the absence of magnetic field, moving electrons does not experience the effect of magnetic field and moves in straight line. Okay, now number two case. Case 2, when small magnetic field is present. In case of magnetic field exists inside the magnetron, the electron emerging from the cathode will slightly deviate from its straight path, which can be easily seen from this curve. Due to small magnetic field, its straight path is slightly deviated. Okay? And this will cause a curvy motion, curved motion or curvy motion of electron from cathode to anode. This motion of the electron is result of the action of electric field as well as magnetic field, magnetic force, due to combined effect of electric and magnetic field. Because I already explained you that magnetic field changes the path of the electron. You know that force FB equal to QV cross B. Okay? And FE equal to EE. That means electric field gives the energy. That means electric force gives the energy to the electron, that is accelerate the electron, and magnetic field gives the variation in the path, that means curved path. Case 3, in case when the magnetic field is further increased, now we again increase the magnetic field, then electrons emerging from the cathode gets highly deflected by the magnetic field and graze along the surface of the cathode. Graze along the surface of the cathode because magnetic field is high. This motion is shown here like that in the presence of large magnetic field. This causes the anode current to be zero. The value of the magnetic field that causes the anode current to be become zero is known as critical magnetic field. Okay? Now, if the magnetic field is increased beyond the critical magnetic field, that means we again increase the magnetic field, what will happen? Then the electrons will bounce back to the cathode itself. Surprising result is that if we are increasing the magnetic field again, then electrons are bounced back. See here, direction is reversed towards the cathode. Electrons will bounce back to the cathode itself without reaching the cathode, without reaching the anode. That means electrons are emitted and such kind of curve path, and electrons itself bounce back towards the cathode. That means they does not reach the anode. So, the reaching of the emitting electron from the cathode back to it is known as backheating. That is very important point for you, that without reaching the electrons to the anode, they reflect back automatically. That means cathode back, and this is known as back heating. So avoid this. Electric supply provided to the cathode must be cut off after oscillations have been set up in the tube. When oscillations set in the cavity, in that case, such kind of electric supply must be cut off. Okay, so this is the case when RF field is not present. When the RF field is present, this first case is when RF input is not present. RF input is not present. Okay, radio frequency input is not present. Now, radio frequency input is present, then what are the cases and how we explain it? Case 1. In case an active RF input is provided to the anode of the magnetron. RF input is provided to the anode. Okay. Then oscillations are set up in the interaction space. Oscillations are set up in the interaction space of the magnetron. So when an electron is emitted from the cathode to the anode, then it, so electrons emitted from the cathode to the anode, then it transfer its energy in order to oscillate. Electrons is emitted from cathode to anode, then it transfer its energy in order to oscillate. Such electrons are known as favored electrons. Okay, in this condition the electrons will have a low velocity. Electrons will have low velocity and thus will take a considerably high amount of time to reach from cathode to anode. It can be seen clearly from here. Electrons are emitted and they take more time for this path. Now, number two case. Another condition arises in the presence of RF input. In this case, the emitted electrons from the cathode while traveling takes energy from the oscillations, thereby resultantly increasing its velocity. Point to be noted that emitted electrons from the cathode, okay, while traveling takes energy from the oscillations. From where they takes energy? From the oscillations, thereby resultantly increasing its velocity. Okay, so despite reaching the anode, the electrons will again bounce back to the cathode, and these electrons are known as unfavored electrons. Okay, and such kind of situation you can easily see seen here. Electrons are emitted and bounce back to the cathode. Now, case number 3, when the RF input is further increased, then electrons emitted while traveling increases its velocity. In order to catch up the electrons emitted earlier with comparatively lower velocity, so all those electrons that do not take energy from the oscillations for their moment are known as favored electrons. Favored electrons does not take energy from the oscillations, and these favored electrons form electron bunch or electron cloud. The electrons are combined at a place, then such kind of bunch is known as electron bunch or electron cloud, and reaches anode from the cathode. Reaches anode from the cathode if RF input is further increased. This formation of electron bunch inside the tube is known as phase foxing effect. what is known as phase focusing effect. Okay, due to this, the orbit of the electron gets confined into spots. Due to this, orbit of electrons gets confined into spots. Okay, these spots rotate according to some fractional value of electron emitted by the cathode until it reaches anode while delivering their energy to oscillations. Very important point that these spots rotate according to some fractional value of electron emitted by the cathode until it reaches anode while delivering their energy to the oscillation. However, the electrons released from the region of cathode between spots will take the energy of the field. From where they take the energy of the field and get back to the cathode very quickly. But this energy is very small in comparison to the energy delivered to the oscillations. So, you can easily see that how such kind of bunch and spokes are there, and movement of electrons, energy emission and given. The movement of favored electrons inside the tube enhances the field existing between the gaps in the cavity. This leads to sustained oscillations inside the magnetron, thereby providing high power energy. Sustained oscillations inside the magnetron and thereby providing high power energy. Okay. Now, the point frequency pushing and pulling. Frequency pushing and pulling. Like as you push the gate and pull the gate. Okay. The variation in the oscillation frequency of the magnetron. What is variation in the oscillation frequency of the magnetron give rise to term frequency pushing and pulling. When the total voltage applied at the anode, of the magnetron is varied, then this causes the variation in the velocity of the electrons moving from cathode to anode. This resultantly changes the frequency of the oscillations. Therefore, we can say that when resonant frequency of the magnetron show variation due to the change in the anode voltage, then it is known as frequency pushing. What is? Magnetron shows variation due to the change in the anode voltage. This is known as frequency pushing, and the change in resonant frequency is sometimes a result of the change in the load impedance of the magnetron. If there is change in the load impedance of the magnetron, then the load impedance varies when the change is purely resistive of reactive. How load impedance changes? It is resistive or reactive. This frequency is known as frequency pulling. Okay, a steady power supply can be provided a reduction in this frequency variation. In this frequency variation, a steady power supply can be provided. Now, what are the advantages of magnetrons? Magnetrons are highly efficient device used for generation of high power microwave signal. Number two, the use of magnetrons in radar can produce radar system of better quality for tracking purpose. It is usually small in size, thus less bulky. Small in size. Disadvantage, quite expensive. Despite producing a wide range of frequency, there exists a drawback in controllability of the generated frequency. problem of controllability of the generated photons. It offers an average power around 1 to 2 kilowatt. Okay, magnetrons are quite noisy. Applications of magnetron. A major application of magnetron is present in a pulsed radar system. Order to produce high power microwave signal. Magnetrons are also used in heating applications. You all know about microwave ovens. Applications in microwave ovens so as to produce fixed frequency oscillations. Tunable magnetrons find their applications in sweep oscillators. It is noteworthy here that this mode of operation of magneton is also known as pi mode. Why this is known as pi mode? Because phase shift is 180 degree is maintained between two adjacent plates. Also, it is to be noted that oscillations are only built up in pi mode. It is also be noted that oscillations are only built up in pi mode. Okay. So, we just understand the magnetron structure and working. You go through this article carefully. Okay. Thank you all of you.